Salt water not good for your car, so what should you end up doing if you end up driving through it like this? We asked the mechanic, and this is new at 9.
See all the steel lines that run under the car. These are subject to corrosion.
Frank Young has seen the effects that salt can have on a car.
If it gets bad enough, yeah, then it's going to get expensive, and how extensive it is depends on where the salt got through the barriers that protect the metals.
In Mapunapuna, we saw car after car after car driving right through it, and some vehicles even parked in the salt water. Over the next several days, roads, especially along the South Shore, may also get inundated with water from the ocean.
If by chance you run over any kind of water, you're not sure if it's salt water or fresh water, the best thing to do is go home and thoroughly wash down the undercarriage of your car.
Yeah, when they shoot the car down, they gotta shoot the middle of the car because there's a lot of lines running through the middle of the car.
If people think that just going to a car wash after is gonna solve the problem, it probably won't, because there aren't very many car washes in Hawaii that have undercarriage sprays.
He says if you're not able to wash the undercarriage and wheels of your car with fresh water immediately, that's okay, because the salt won't do damage right away.
You know, a few days of salt on your vehicle is not going to do any damage. So, you know, maybe sometime next week, after this whole king tide is gone, that people should just thoroughly wash their car down, shoot water inside of your brake drums, into your tires, wash down your aluminum rims.
And if you don't, he says the humidity will keep the salt alive and it'll just keep eating away at the metal.
Over time, then, you're going to start having leaking brake lines or leaking fuel lines because the salt just sits there.
So knowing that and to avoid the hassle, the best thing to do is don't drive through the salt water and take another route if you can.